Hello, fellow YouTubers. It's me, Love Bono, but you can call me Vicky. I want to start out by thanking everyone who left a comment about my previous video, my rant video, about the thumbs down on a grandkid video. The first thing that came to mind as I read through the comments, I was thinking how much I wish I could cook a meal for all of you. Just have you all together in one room and let me cook for you. That in itself is a little weird.
No wonder I get thumbs down.
That's weird, but that's what came to mind. I will be responding to everyone who left a comment personally. Thank you. I didn't know why I had to do that video, but now I do. I needed that support. It made it okay. Well, no, it didn't. I'm still a little hurt by the thumbs down. And did you see I got 3 thumbs down on the rant video? But really, I'm okay. I kind of laughed about them. You just have to wonder, who's the person and what are they going through that does that? Do they think it's funny? Does it make them feel better? And, you know, here's what comes to mind when you get a thumbs down, or at least my mind. I feel like, gosh, they don't like me, / they don't like my layouts. And that makes me feel sad, but then I have to think, why are you watching my videos? Why would you even spend enough time? I just wonder, do they like watch the video for a second or a minute and then thumbs down it? I don't know. And then leave? Or do they continue to watch and thumbs down? I don't know. It seems weird to me, but I've always told my son, everybody's different. We'll never understand why certain people do certain things. Imagine, some people pick vanilla, some people pick chocolate. The way I feel, why would you eat vanilla when chocolate is available? But to other people, they love the vanilla. It's the way the mind is wired. So, we'll never know, but here's what I got to say. As said before, the good in this community far outweighs the bad. And I'm back because I got to share my layouts with you guys, whether someone likes them or not. Okay, let's get going. All of the layouts are Christmas oriented. This is my grandson. I printed these photos up. They're like 2x3. On my selfie cannon that I won from O Snap Gonzo. Thank you again, Sandra. I was just saying the other day when I was using the cannon selfie printer cannon, that Walgreens must think I died. I haven't been there in so long. And I'm going to tell you, if you don't have a printer at home, it's definitely worth the investment. I feel like it lets me be a little bit more spontaneous in what layout I want to do. If I have a certain paper or embellishment and I want to do a layout of a digital photo, all of our photos are digital, of course, and I don't have that photo, I used to have to wait until I could pick it up from Walgreens. No problem, because they do 1 hour developing. But I don't know about you. Sometimes, by the time I get ready and go to Walgreens and pick up the picture, it's not 1 hour, it's 2 hours. And by then, my mojo has escaped. He's ran off again and left me sitting here blank. I love the Canon selfie. And that's what I did. I put these, like this is a 4x6. I used something called Photo Sheet. I will leave the link to the website down below. It's a totally free software. You can use it on your computer, your laptop, and like you can take a 4x6 photo or photo format and put two pictures on it. You can put four pictures on it. They can all be the same. They can be different. I think it's kind of like that one picked something or another for phones. But this is not for phones, though. I ran this paper through my Cuddlebug using the Brick embossing folder. I am going to use my embossing folders. Why wouldn't I? I buy them. I may as well use them for something other than cards. I forced myself to use the embossing folders this year for some of the Christmas cards, all four of them that I sent out. You'll see this is those little wood veneers. I think that's from the Brighton Beach collection by Studio Calico, I think. I'm using some of my old brands because I have a zillion, and these are from October Afternoon. Oh, this little stocking here is just Recollections. It's from one of those little sheets of stickers, 3D stickers. I colored this. He's from Paper Smooches. These are rub-ons from God knows who. And background paper, it's from a paper stack, but I don't know which one. And this is a picture of my grandson riding his big Christmas present. We got him something called the Crazy Cart. And man, oh man, I need to do a video on this. It was a great purchase, but that little thing is fast. My son even got on it, and he loved it. When we were thinking about buying it, where did I go but YouTube to do some research? So I'd like to do a video and tell people about it. It's expensive, but I think it's well worth the price. He will probably be able to use this until he's 14 or 15 years old. I think it has like a 250-pound weight limit. The paper on this layout is from the Heidi Swap Christmas stack. I think it may be from last year, actually. These little letters here are the Tim Holtz stickers. They came in like a little matchbook type of holder. Studio Calico Stars and Camera. This, gosh, has to be 2 years old. I'm really using up my stash, and I'm using items that I've not used in a long time. Some washi tape back here, a button. These are my mind's eye, and it's like the little chipboard buttons 2 to 4 years ago. Another brand. I splattered some paint. I cut myself a little banner here. Some random flare buttons. You'll notice I tried. My stupid camera just cut off. I love this Canon for taking pictures and videos, but it cuts off like every 8 to 12 minutes, and I've never been able to figure out why. So if I repeat myself, I apologize. That's some random flare badges. I tried to pull that blue out a little bit. I remember watching scrapbook series on DIY like 6 to 8 years ago, and somebody was on, I think it might have been Anna Griffin, which I love, that said when you use color or pattern on your layouts, think of it as one color, use it as a pint, use one color as a quart, and one color as a gallon. You guys probably recognize these. I think they're Studio Calico acetate words. They're some thickers. I printed out these two pictures on it, 1 4x6 format, and not much more to explain. I really like the way this turned out. It's totally not my style, so I like when I color outside the lines. This is another Christmas picture, myself and my son. This is Avalanche by Basil. Some random recollection stickers from Michaels. These are all from a 12 by 12 sticker sheet. Couldn't tell you what it is. I was just dying to use my green gingham ribbon. I don't know what to do with ribbon like that, but I love it. And through the years, I bought so much. I'm not sure that I'm crazy about this layout, but I got to use my ribbon. And buttons. My gosh, those are those Teresa Collin buttons that came out around the holidays several years ago. Finally using them. The layered papers are also from a paper stack. I think it is a Recollections paper stack, but I really liked it. I loved the pinks in it. And I had so many paper stacks this year for Christmas with pinks in them. One of my main purchases at Christmas time was the Candy Cane Lane by Bo Bunny. And it had so much pink in it, but I loved it. So guess what I did? Bought a pink sweater to wear. I wanted to dress the boys in pink, but he's all man, as you can tell by the grip. Anyway, I cut out with my utility knife the Santas so that they would stick up over the photo. It's layered, and that's my apron punch from EK Success. And I did some sewing, of course, to keep the ribbon on. As you know, if you've watched even two of my videos, I have all boys. One biological son, one biological grandson, two step-grandsons, and two stepsons. I have noticed that they will look at the scrapbook albums that I put together if the titles are good, if it's about them, if there's some humor to it. They are not looking for design elements. They are not looking for mixed media. They're looking for something humorous. So I always try to make my titles witty. And sometimes I fail. But this one says, "Good Lord, what is wrong with Logan?" And the poor kid, this is for New Year's Eve. He had been sick as a dog. He was coming out of it here, but he would still have those little coughing fits. So these pictures I actually obtained from a video that I was taking during the holidays. There is software called VLC. And this software will let you play your videos and snag photographs, JPEGs, GIFs, pictures from the movie. I'll leave that link down below too. I mean, gosh, how great is it now? Instead of having 3 million pictures
of any event, I'll have 10 million.
This is October afternoon. This is Doodlebug. This is Studio Calico. I sprayed it with Mr. Huey Rudolph. I feel that Mr. Huey Rudolph is the truest, brightest of the Christmas red paints and sprays. And you'll see, these are just some little stickers I cut out. Here, I had a rub-on, and it said, ho, ho, ho. So I put, ho, oh, oh. All I did is flipped it upside down. Genius, right? These are, I don't know where the stickers come from. That's Doodlebug, though. As is the paper back here. And I don't know about that, though. You know, that might not be Doodlebug. I'll check and leave the name of the paper pads that I used down in the Dropbox, okay? So anyway, it says, "Good Lord, what is wrong with Logan? Bless his heart. Logan was just getting over a terrible cold. He still had a cough. I caught this picture from a video camera on New Year's Eve, and it says the season, and I stuck the flu season in there. The kids will get a kick out of it. But gosh, I mean, look at him. And he was a good sport. I'll tell you, I had such a good time on New Year's Eve. I had Nate and Logan. I had a blast. This will be the front picture in my 2014 Christmas album. As usual, me, my son, and my grandson. I know Nate has his eyes closed, but of all the pictures to use for the front page, I wanted something where we look decent. I take a horrible picture, so I had to find something where I looked at least halfway decent, and I could find nothing where all of us were doing well. I figured 2 out of 3 isn't bad. This is the Bow Bunny Candy Cane Collection. I love it. It's so soft and pastel-y and pretty. The banner is a Bow Bunny. You'll see I did some stitching up here and then ruffle. Camera cut off, so I'll back up. This, that, this, these, this, all Bow Bunny, all the papers. Bow Bunny Candy Cane Lane. I did some stitching and ruffled the edges to give it texture. You'll see I sprinkled some teal Heidi Swap spray ink. There are random stickers. Don't know where they come from. Here's that little Studio Calico resin bobby pin reindeer. All the wood is Studio Calico. Stuck some a puffy label or puffy sticker over here, right there, and on the holiday season word. I love puffy stickers. Love them. As I zoom in here for you, you'll see on my flare button, it said December, but I stuck on puffy stickers. One of the little dots is missing. It's supposed to look like snow. Somebody did a video and they put stickers on their flare, and I just thought that was such a great idea. I will have to leave you the name of these stickers. They're recently released, like in the past 2 to 3 months, I would say, and they match the Candy Cane Lane collection perfectly. They're beautiful. So I'll leave the name to them down below. But it just says Holiday Season 2014. And I just hung some of the little stickers off of the words. I love the 12x12 sticker sheets and the 6x12. I also love myself some chipboard, but I buy it and I don't use it. But I am now. I mean, look at this little guy. How cute is that? Oh, the paper. You'll see, because I've probably zoomed in on it by now. If not, I'll do it again. It is a wood grain white 12x12 paper. The only place I've ever been able to find this in the past year is paperissues.com.